So today is cycling up Mount Doug twice.
Jesse, it's great to see you still rolling here. We're getting close to your big event. And I wanted to talk to you about a couple things today. One is gear selection, and one is effort and effort parameters. I know you've been experiencing a few different things, and so let's address those. So gear selection is really important. Now that is, when I say gear selection, I mean what gear are you in on your bike? And bikes these days, we're lucky in that they have lots of gears. I'm guessing that your bike probably has 10 or 11 speeds on the back that are available to you, as well as a big ring and a small ring at the front, which effectively doubles your gearing. So you probably have somewhere between 20 and 24 gears or something on that bike. So there's lots of room for you to have different gears. And what the gears allow you to do is basically maintain a steady RPM or a steady cadence with a similar effort. So selecting the gear that you're in is really, really important for a whole bunch of things. It's important so that you can control your RPM or your cadence. It's important so you can control your effort, right? Like if you're in your hardest gear and always pushing your hardest gear, that's going to be harder to do. And likewise, if you're in too easy a gear, your legs are going to spin like a crazy man. So we don't want that either. So gear selection is important. Now, I can talk to you till I'm blue in the face about gear selection. The best way to get better at selecting gears is to actually go ride your bike. And thankfully, you've been doing tons of that, which is great. So I'm sure you'll notice as you become more proficient on the bike that your hands are probably moving more frequently to adjust to the terrain. So if you're riding up to a hill, you're going to start instinctively shifting maybe into an easier gear. Certainly when you get on the hill, you're going to notice if, you know, your leg speed slows down and it gets harder, you're going to shift into an easier gear. So as you become more experienced, you're going to start anticipating those changes a little bit sooner. And part of that is looking up the road. So are you able to look ahead and say, hey, you know what? I have a hill coming up. It gradually gets steeper. So maybe I can roll into that, but eventually I'm going to have to shift into an easier gear. Likewise, let's say you're cresting the top of a hill and you know that it starts to roll downwards, you're going to want to get on shifting into a harder gear so that you can keep applying pressure to the pedals, right? So gear selection is really, really important. And part of it is just having the mindfulness to be looking ahead to see what's coming. And then you can select the right gears. Cool? Easy? Now, effort. I know that's another one. You had a hilarious story today. You had Mount Doug hill reps. Now, for those watching that are not familiar with Mount Doug, it's probably the steepest. It's not the longest, but certainly one of the steepest climbs that we have here in Victoria. Very aggressive. It's about a mile in length, and there's no reprieve. It just gets steadily steeper and steeper. And I know you were pretty gassed by the top of that. And I've told you quite a few times now that I purposely send you on hills because it forces you into the effort that I want you into. And that hill is long enough that there is no escaping it. And I think you found on your first rep that the effort just by about 1,500 meters of about 1,600, you're like totally gassed and you were done. But you got back on your bike and you finished it off. So good for you. One of the things that you'll notice that I always give you are recovery intervals. And this time I was very specific in that I wanted you to have 10 minutes of recovery because I knew how hard that climb would be for you. So 10 minutes is a nice length of time for you to fully recover so you can then get back to that effort that you will need to get up the climb. Now, if you're doing a 5-6 minute climb, and you want to really go after it, if we look at sort of a scale of 1 to 10 on effort, you know, a 10 being an all-out max sprint Well, you're not going to be able to do that for 5 or 6 minutes. It's physically impossible. I mean, that's what you would do for 100 meters. So if we're using that scale of 1 to 10 perceived effort scale, you're probably going to do, you know, a 4, 5, 6 minute climb at about an 8.5 to a 9 out of 10. So it's unsustainable over the long term, but you can kind of hang out there for 4, 5, 6 minutes and it's awful. Like you feel like you're going to puke. And that's the kind of effort I wanted you to have on that climb. And I knew sending you on that climb that there'd be no escaping that. Like you couldn't fake it. You had to go there and the hill itself would pull that out of you. So effort is a sliding scale. The shorter the interval I give you, typically the higher the intensity needs to be. So if I give you 30 second intervals, I'm expecting those to be super hard. And if I give you 30 minute intervals, like a time trial, for example, then that effort's probably going to be around an 8 out of 10. So learning how to gauge what effort to go is really, really important. And you'll see in the program, more often than not, I'm giving you a percentage, so 65 to 70% for your really long rides, or I'm just sending you to a hill like Mount Doug where I know I'm going to get the effort I need out of you. So effort is really important. So let's recap again. Scale of 1 to 10 is the easiest way to do it until you have some measurement tools. And by tools, I mean heart rate monitor, power meters on a bike are really good. I don't think you need those things yet. Let's just use perceived effort. So scale of 1 to 10, 10 being a max sprint, 1 being you're barely pedaling at all, coasting down a hill, no pedaling. And everything in between is important to know how to feel. And the other thing we talked about was gear selection. And a big part of that is looking up the road to see what's coming so that you can anticipate. And then getting more and more comfortable using your gear levers to shift you into a gear that both allows you to stay in the effort that we want you and stay on the cadence range that we want you. And now, one thing you've mentioned to me is that you don't have a cadence meter. You don't have something that's telling you what the RPM is. That's totally fine. You can do a little count. So if you're just pedaling along the road, do a 10-second count and multiply by 6. That's pretty easy. And you don't need to do it all the time, because eventually your body's gonna settle into that rhythm and it's gonna feel what that feels like. And cadence is important. So when I give you those cadence parameters, you can kind of just check in with it over a 10-second count, multiply by 6, and you'll have your number roughly, and eventually your body will get comfortable at the cadence ranges that I'm looking for. All right, Jesse, keep it up, buddy. You're doing great, and we'll see you next week.